All right, so we're working on our Turtles in Time. We're in my workshop. That's what we're going to call that. And what we've got going here is we've got some new buttons and some old buttons. I ordered all new buttons for the machine. So Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the original game, came with leaf switches. Turtles in Time, the original cabinets, came with micro switches, which are these kind of switches. we have Turtles in Time. We're trying to restore it to as close to as original as possible. So we're going to go with micro switches. And leaf switches are way more expensive. So I didn't really even look into that. We just got replacement HAP, Suzu HAP buttons. And the micro switches are an E-switch, which I'm not really familiar with. The ones that were in there were cherries, and most of them are still good, so we might leave the original actual switch itself in there and just replace the buttons. But we're gonna try the E-switches out, just see how they work. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. First things first, we have our harnesses for the buttons and joysticks. And there's four players, so there's four harnesses. This player one's in good shape. There's really no issues with player one. Player one's looking good. This is player, and I should have probably separated this before I started the video, but I didn't. And it's just a jumbled mess. Get out of there. Okay, so player two I think was pretty good too. Yeah, player two's in good shape. There's really no issues there. So player two's good. player four is in terrible shape. The ground is the only, oh wait, no, there's one other one. Ground is the only wire that has the quick disconnects on it. So these are the quick disconnects. I don't know if you can see those or not. I should probably just flip my camera around. Sorry, this is first video, so I'm still getting used to this. So the quick disconnects, they look like that on the old switches. See if I can get it to zoom on that or not. I don't know. These are pretty much required. Sometimes operators run out of these, I think, and so they would just solder the wire directly to the switch, which makes it a pain in the ass if the switch ever goes, because you have to get all that solder off. So what we're going to do tonight, and this is player, well, whichever one I didn't say, player three. Ground just fell off. So player three, same thing, missing tons of disconnects. These were all soldered on, which if you saw my pictures of the Turtles in Time, originally, there were soldering all over the control panel. So we soldered all that. We got rid of it. So we're going to replace all those. Ouch. Or we're gonna not gonna replace them because they're not there, but we're gonna add them with these. Bad light, there you go. Okay, so these are just 0.187 red, fully insulated quick disconnects. I tried one of these on the micro switch, and they're tough to get on. So when I'm setting up the control panel, I'm going to be gentle putting these on originally until I make sure that everything's on there correctly, and then I'm going to take and actually fully seat them. But right now they're tough little disconnects, so they stick onto the switch really tight. So we've got our quick disconnects, we've got our ratcheting disconnect tool. Basically, you just You put your wire in the disconnect, you put your disconnect in the ratcheting tool, and you just squeeze it, and it'll clamp everything down for you. You don't need this, but I got this at Harbor Freight for like, I think it was on sale for $15, and then Harbor Freight always has a coupon, so you just like go online and look for a 20% off coupon, and that's what I did. So we're going to get all this set up. We're going to get the switches, or actually the wiring harnesses set up with all the disconnects on them, so we can actually set everything up easily and not have to worry about it. So we're going to get to recording that right now. Okay, so here is our wiring harness, and here is our ground right here. And we'll just start here because we've already got a piece of this falling apart. And this is all what the original operator already had in there. And you can see, maybe you can see, I don't know, but it's got solder on them. I'm probably not going to clean that solder up. I'm just going to throw the disconnect on and see if it fits. And if it does, we'll leave it. And it doesn't. Okay, so we need to go get our soldering iron. All right, let's go get our soldering iron so we can clean those wires up. Okay, soldering iron is warming up right now. So what we're going to do is we're just going to go through on some of these other switches and see how they look. That one can use a little bit of wire trimmed off. So we just got a little bit of new wire there. And this is just an automatic wire puller. These things are awesome. They are worth their weight in gold. I don't really deal with the old manual style wire pullers or wire strippers anymore. They're way too much work, and I'm not that motivated. So we'll just put our disconnect on there, and we just close it right around the actual switch. Make sure the wire is pushed in nice and tight. Oh, this thing's tough. And give it a good squeeze, and there we go. So you can see it's got a nice little, I don't know if we can zoom in and see the crimp, but that's what it looks like. It crimps really nice. Gives you a nice solid crimp. This has a lot of wire left on it, so we're just going to trim a little bit off. And the reason I'm trying to save as much wire as I can is because the control panel was absolutely butchered. And if you saw my pictures of the cabinet, you saw that. Whoever was in there working on it originally, you gotta have some sympathy for guys working on site. But it was just terrible, shoddy work. It wasn't very good. Things were hooked up poorly, and it looked ugly. So we're gonna clean it up, but we're also, God, there's not a lot of wire there. I hate to do it, but I'm gonna have to cut that. We're also gonna try to save some money. We don't, I don't have these Molexes. I'm sure it's like a standard JAMA Molex, but I don't know, this is a new hobby for me. So I don't have a ton of stuff. With regards to like arcade specific stuff. I've got a bunch of electrical stuff. Because I do a fair bit of electrical work. I kind of started doing electrical work when I was, I think first time I did anything electrical, wrong tool, was when my dad got us a VCR. Me and my brother got us a VCR. And so that was probably when I was, 10 or so. So that would have been like 1990, 1991, somewhere in there. And so VCRs were expensive back in the day. And we rented one a lot. You rented VCRs because if you couldn't afford one, you just rent one from the video store, and then you could watch your movies, and you'd turn the movie in the VCR, and you're good to go. But Anyway, so my dad got us a VCR, and it was stolen, of course, because we were poor. And the first thing I did, I think we had it for like maybe a day, maybe 2 days, and I immediately took it apart. And I was just like addicted from that point forward. I loved taking stuff apart. I loved figuring out how things worked, which eventually got me into electrical stuff because I liked video games. But again, we were poor, so our stuff always broke. And I'd always have to fix it. So I'd take it apart, figure out what the problem was, and fix it as best I could. And so then, you know, when the original PlayStation came out, when the original PlayStation came out, PlayStation 1, you know, that, around that time I was big into computers, you know, and I'm still pretty big into computers. I like gaming computers. I just like computers in general. They're helpful tools. I know that's weird in today's age. Anyways, we'd be playing these PS1 games, and, you know, I was a big fighting game guy. I love fighting games. I've always loved fighting games. You know, the first time I played Mortal Kombat, I played the arcade, and I figured out how to do a special move. I think it was, I'm almost positive it was Scorpion's harpoon thing. And when I first learned how to do that, I gotta cut this one too. It was just so amazing to me. But anyways, fighting games, always been a big fan of. Playing PS1, we couldn't get the newest fighting games very quickly. They took a while to come from Japan. Man, I cut off a lot of wire there. Oh well. Hopefully I can still make that work. I remember Tekken 2, I think it was, took forever to get to the United States. Everybody wanted to play Tekken 2. We were all, you know, looking on ways to do that, and one of the guys we knew, he had a mod chip in his PlayStation. I don't remember how he got it, but he had a mod chip in his PlayStation, so he had an imported copy of Tekken 2 that he could play. It was still a legit Japanese copy of Tekken 2, but because his PlayStation was modded, it wasn't region locked, so he could play Japanese games on it, and that just blew my mind. I was like, oh my god, I have to have that. So I figured out how to mod PlayStations, which involved installing a chip on the motherboard of the PlayStation, and it's fairly rudimentary. I mean, there's not a whole lot to it. I think it was like 6 wires or something like that, but it's fairly small solder points. So I had to do that. I had to have my PlayStation modded so I could play, you know, the newest fighting games. And then Sega Saturn came out, and Sega Saturn had, and I'm almost positive, it probably still is to today, it had the best version of X-Men versus Street Fighter, which was my favorite game. I loved that game. I could not get enough of that game. So the Sega Saturn, I hate cutting all these wires. Stupid control panel is going to fight me on it, so I'm probably going to have to rewire a bunch of this, but let's just start here at the starting point. Anyway, so the Sega Saturn had X-Men versus Street Fighter. You had to have the RAM cart, of course, and you had to have a Japanese Sega Saturn, because that's another game that never came out in America. I had to figure out how to mod a Sega Saturn so I could play X-Men versus Street Fighter on it. That was a pretty big task. Sega Saturn was tough to mod, a lot harder than the PlayStation. But I modded it. I ordered my X-Men versus Street Fighter cart, because you had to have the disc, and then you had to have the extra RAM card. It was like the expansion card for the N64. many grounds is that? That's not nearly enough grounds. Where are some grounds? Right there. So anyways, yeah, Sega Saturn, X-Men vs. Street Fighter, you had to have the expansion RAM cart, so it could add more RAM. It had to be modded, so it could play Japanese games. And I had all that, and life was good. That was a fun time. I mean, back in those days, there was nothing. I mean, you couldn't play those games at home any other way. And the PlayStation one was terrible. For some reason, I don't even remember why. But it wasn't good. Or maybe it never even came out for PlayStation. I don't remember. And the Saturn Saturn pad was such a much better stick for fighting games. It was just such a better controller. It was like made for fighting games. I don't know. People still mod that controller. They still use that controller for fighting games. To this day. I mean, you can go on Amazon or eBay or something, and I guarantee you will find people out there with that controller, people selling that controller. We need to clean up our soldering iron here, so we got our little Hacko ball of metal, I don't know, spaghetti or whatever. This stuff is amazing. I don't know what it is, but it cleans soldering tips like perfectly. It's, I don't know what it's made of, but you used to have like a sponge, and you have a wet sponge, and you'd clean it on there, and then if your soldering iron sucked, you'd have to wait for it to warm back up, and just a goofy thing. And so I'm just trying to get a little bit of the solder off so I can actually fit it in the disconnect. Can we get it? I think it's going in. Is it in? I think it was in. It's really hard to tell. Get in there. Get in the hole. Oh, these disconnects are tough. Alright, we're gonna cut fresh. That one's good. This one is just, it's ugly. I really don't, I'm dreading cutting these because there's just so much customization, I think, is the best word to use in that control panel. And I know it wasn't the guy I got it from. The guy I got the Turtles in Time from is a buddy of mine. I've known him since high school, and I don't think he ever did any work to that machine. He's had it for years in his garage, and it's just kind of sat there, and him and his son played it. But the monitor started going, there we go, that's going perfect. The monitor started going out on it, and I was begging him for the longest time to sell it to me. And he finally did. So, Tom, if you're watching, I'm going to send this video to you, but if you're watching, thank you so much for selling me the Turtles in Time. Really appreciate it. Now you can watch me build it. That one actually doesn't look too bad, that joint right there. We'll keep that one. Maybe. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that'll get in there. Yeah, and when they soldered it, they burnt up the wiring, too. Come on. You take pride in your work. If you're going to do something, do it right, you know what I mean? I hate that. I hate when people halfway do something. Like, if you're going to do it correctly. And, you know, if you're watching this and you have recommendations, you have tips for me, for stuff I'm not doing right, please, by all means, tell me. I'd love to know if I'm not doing something right. If you know a better way, I'd love to hear it. You know, it's always good to improve on whatever you do. it doesn't make sense to just be at a standstill for everything. I'm going to try to clean this up, but I don't think I'm going to be able to. This is really ugly. Oh, I need something to... Here. Oh, here's a screw. We're just going to kind of get this a little hot. Get that solder moving a little bit. Let's try to push it down. And I'm not worried about this table. This table has taken a beating. I've had this table for years. So I'll stick solder and hot whatever on this table. Who cares? Yeah, it's not gonna go. We gotta cut it. Shoot! We gotta cut a bunch of this stuff. It's gonna suck. I don't wanna do it, but I have to. God, that's getting short. Oh well. Oh, I gotta cut the other side. What am I doing? That's one, you know, we got to check and make sure we got enough grounds after we do this. If we don't have enough grounds, we're going to have to add wire. So we'll do that before we do the last one. And... okay. Beautiful. Little $12 Harbor Freight crimpers, a rock star. I love it. Harbor Freight, I mean, people hate on Harbor Freight a lot, because, you know, it's cheap. It's cheap stuff. It's not the greatest quality, but, I mean, a tool like this, a crimper, I mean, how can you really go wrong? It does its job. There's really not a whole lot to it to fail. So, I mean, I guess, whatever. If you don't want to use it, spend... you know, instead of spending $12, spend your $40 on the Klein version or whatever, but that ain't for me. I'll take my $12 one. Works good. I got a lot of Harbor Freight tools. There's no way that's going to be long enough. I don't know how I'm going to make that work. We'll find out. Okay, so let's do the math. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We've got 6 total grounds. So we've got 2 buttons, so that's 2, and then 4 buttons for the controllers. So that's 6 total. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we're doing good. So I think that one's actually done. I believe that was player 3, my little tag fell off at some point. Yeah, that's 6. Okay. Get that one out of the way, and now we're going to move on to player 4. And player 4 I don't think was as bad. Player 4, who was Raphael, had an issue with one of the wires. One of the wires had fallen out of the Molex. And you can see here, again, I don't have these Molexes. These are, I'm sure, it's like a hot, not a hot, but a JAMA standard. And so, you know, in the future, maybe I'll get some of these, but I need the tool to actually get the wire into the plugs on there, which I don't have. So what I did is, there you can see there's a little tab inside of there on the actual little bullet or whatever you call that thing. I just pushed the tab in and pulled it out, and I've done this before with lots of stuff. It works, and I put the wire back in there. I kind of bent it back in so I could get the wire in, and then I just soldered it, and I stuck it back in, and it's solid. It's not going anywhere, so it'll work. Not exactly the correct way of doing it, but it does work, and it's affordable. You know, it's cheap. I have all that stuff. You know, once I get more into the hobby, once I get some more stuff, maybe some more games, which I do have another game in the garage. We'll talk about that sometime. Once I get into it more, you know, learn a little bit more, we'll gather some of this stuff up, stuff that we need, common stuff. You know, I've been reading a lot on John's Arcade, on Reddit. There are some people on Reddit, believe it or not, that they're into the arcade stuff. And then Clove. I've been reading a lot on Clove, too. And I'm just trying to, you know, learn. I mean, a lot of the stuff is kind of basic. Stuff you should know if you've done electrical work before. But some of it's pretty specific. I've never worked on a monitor before, so getting the monitor working, which I did before I had the video camera, that was pretty monumental for me. You know, you're sitting there wiring all this stuff up, and you have no idea if it's going to work or not. And, I mean, it's kind of you take a deep breath before you hit the power switch on that thing. And, I mean, it's a K7000 monitor, which I guess has a reputation of having some issues, but I mean, it's not the worst monitor out there. I thought it was easy to work on. As far as soldering went, wasn't very hard. But you know, you got to discharge the monitor, and that, you know, the first time you do that, you kind of panic a little bit, and then you don't want to get lax on discharging monitors, because it's high voltage. That can do some damage to you. But I mean, it's, you know, you're installing like 20 capacitors. You gotta make sure all the capacitors are in there the right way. You got the right polarity. They're, you know, they're the right capacitor for the board where you are. You know, where you're actually installing it. So you turn on that monitor. It can be a little exciting. But you know, once you do it and it's working, it's like the best feeling. You're like, oh man, I fixed this thing. And that monitor that I have for it is, I mean, it's in fantastic shape. There's no burn-in, none at all that you can see. I mean, it looks great. It starts up relatively quick. It's a good little machine, I think. And it's going to be fun to play. You know, we have parties and stuff. We don't have any kids yet. Hopefully one day, but... you know, if we have parties and stuff, we're going to have people down here playing it. Want to get a dart board, too. That'd be fun. People like playing darts. I like playing darts. I was in a dart league with my dad for a long time. That was pretty fun. Dart league. Such an old person thing to do. Oh. Kind of fun. Competition. I hope that one's in there. But yeah, just kind of getting into the arcade thing, having fun doing it. Could, you know, I'm a big tinkerer. I love to tinker with stuff. Like, you know, I'll show you guys in the future kind of what I tinker with, things that I kind of spend my time doing. It's not very exciting, but I mean, it's getting stuff working. I like getting stuff working. If you saw my shirt, it's a Bearded Lady Motorcycle Rally shirt. Because Bearded Lady's awesome. It's a motorcycle rally they have in Minnesota. They didn't have it this year, which really bummed me out. I guess they're supposed to be bringing it back, but I don't know. But I go there because I've got a couple motorcycles. One's a 1978 XS 650 Special, and the other is a 1980 XS 1100, which is a pretty big bike for its day. They're both Yamahas. See, you get Yamaha tattoos because I love riding Yamahas. But you know, it's just something to work on, something to fix. And they were both in pretty rough shape when I got them. My buddy kind of helped me get into bikes, and he kind of worked on them with me, kind of showed me the ropes, and I kind of took it from there. Great thing about the internet, man, is everything's out there. If you want to fix something, you can probably figure out how to do it on the internet. You can probably get parts for it on the internet. It might cost you some money, but you can probably do it. Okay, where's my ground on this one? My ground on player 4, I feel, is quite a bit longer than player 3's. Maybe it's in my head. Let's take a look. It is. I know that's player 1's. Player 1's ground's way longer. Ooh, we're going to see how it works. Hopefully it works. If it doesn't, we redo it. Then we don't have a choice but to get the Molex stuff. It's going to be... Well, I wanted to save some money. Well, that didn't happen. And I'm sure... I don't know. I got all my buttons and my joysticks, which I got today. I'll show you guys those here in a little bit. I got all those from, like, Arcade Control or Arcade. I don't know. I'll find the box here and I'll tell you. But anyways, I had... hat buttons, they had ball tops, which is what I wanted to go with, because the original Turtles in Time had ball tops instead of bat tops. So they had both of those, so I said, okay, well, these are the ones I need. So I ordered it from them. I also ordered the wrong light bulbs. So I thought I was getting the right ones, but apparently they were not. Light bulbs I need are like 555s, I think, or something like that. So I ordered the wrong ones. Big surprise. I don't think I'm not gonna turn the soldering iron on. I don't need anything soldered here. I'm just gonna cut it off and kinda see what I end up with. I kinda cross our fingers. Oh man, that one's not gonna work. There we go. Green one. If I could get away with one of these ones decided on not being completely shot, I'd be happy. But it doesn't look like that's going to happen for me. And I don't think this wiring is the original color. I have no idea if these are the right colors or not. So I took a bunch of pictures, which I posted on Reddit, John's Arcade. I thought about posting on Cloud, but you had to go through like some ritual to post anything on there. So I mean, I'll probably do it. I'm asking like to donate some money to. I think it was like $1 or $10 or something to some video game arcade thing. Or like Heart Arcade Museum or something like that. Which, I mean, that's probably a good way to spend your money. But I just never got around to it. I posted on, posted the album on Imgur. And then John's Arcade. And then Reddit. Is that everything? Did I really wire everything already? I think I did. Sweet. Cool. Everything's wired. Yeah, that one's solid. This is that wire I redid. Seems solid to me. Alright. Well, let's go hook up player 1. Or no, I don't think I installed one of the joysticks, like temporarily installed it, because I still gotta get the all the carriage bolts. I haven't got a tumbler yet, so I need to get a tumbler and let those tumble. but I installed temporarily Player 2.
Let's go take a look at him. Let's go see what that stuff looks like.
Okay. So here we've got Player 2, who's Michelangelo. And we were worried about Michelangelo because I was worried about a lot of the pictures I saw. The TMT-1 control panel had yellow for Michelangelo. At least that's what it looks like on the internet. Like every picture I looked at, they all looked like yellow for the original TMNT. Turtles in Time was orange. It was definitely orange. So I wanted to make sure that I got an orange ball top to match orange buttons. The buttons that were on here were orange and they were convex, which they did not use. I know for a fact they didn't have any convex buttons. So I had to replace those. The rest of the buttons I did not have to install, or have to replace rather. I chose to because I wanted to just have brand new buttons. And I'm sure I'll use those buttons, the original, someday. For something, if you know, just keep messing with the hobby, because who doesn't need buttons? So the ball top, I mean, it's perfect in my eyes. I think they did a fantastic job. What's the name of this company? Twisted Quarter. Sorry, Twisted Quarter, not Arcade Controls. Twisted Quarter is where I got these, and that was one of the companies I had saw that John had ordered from. So I looked at a bunch of different companies when I was getting parts, and I liked Twisted Quarter setup. I thought they had some really nice stuff. There is a company that's here in Minnesota who I had sent a message to on Facebook to try to get some more information back from them, but they never responded. It took them, I think they just responded like a day or two ago, and I already got my buttons. They said they were at a fighting game convention or whatever, and I was like, that's okay, you know. I'll hear from you guys in the future. So, I can't remember the name. I think it was Arcade Paradise or Paradise Arcade. Paradise Arcade, I think it was. So they're right in Minnesota. I'm in Minnesota. I don't have my, just so you guys know, I don't have a microphone. So you're kind of dealing with my camera's sound, which isn't the greatest, I know. I will be getting a mic here so I can dictate these a little bit better. But let's start by putting all our grounds on, so we at least know that we have enough and that they're going to reach. So ground's always on the outside, and you can kind of just slide it on. Oh, this is going to be so tight. Oh, it's going to be really tight. Get that up there. We should just redo this whole thing. Just rewire the whole ground. Take that pin out. Resolder it. Actually, no, I think this is going to work. I think this is going to work. Yep. I think it will. Okay. Cool. Cool. Grounds are all on. Beautiful. And this is just a test run. I haven't permanently mounted anything. There's still a few more things I need to do with regards to the joysticks and the control panel. So the control panel looks great. I mean, this is original. And I'm pretty sure this was a conversion, so it's the original from the conversion of the original TMNT. It's the Lexan or the Plexi, whatever this is. It came out really well. It was ugly. It was really ugly. I might get a new sheet someday, but right now I think I like this one. It's got a big scratch. It goes straight across here, and there's a gigantic ding right there. I don't even know how that would happen. Maybe somebody punched it with like a ring. I don't know. But that's okay. It looks okay. It doesn't look perfect, but it looks good. I'm not looking to make this machine like immaculate. It's gonna have some scars, you know. But the artwork it is perfect. I mean, beautiful. The artwork came out so nice after I scrubbed it and scrubbed it and scrubbed it. I couldn't believe it. I thought for sure I'd have to get new artwork for the control panel, but I didn't. It looks really good. And I'll probably give you a better angle of that so you can see it. But I gotta get my pictures from before I wired this up, or unwired everything, so I can at least check it out and make sure I set all the buttons up correctly. So hold on for one second. Okay, guys, I'm back. I printed it out. A picture of Michelangelo's buttons that I originally took. So we're just gonna open it up. Stick our picture like there, so we can reference it. It looks like orange and yellow goes. I'm just gonna try to pull these wires out so I can clean them up a little bit. Organize this wiring harness a little bit better as I work. So orange and yellow goes over here. Yeah. Right? Yeah. So orange and yellow is there. And these are the original disconnects, so these are a lot easier to get out. I actually didn't think there's any disconnects on this wiring harness because they were all still there. You always go to the outside, that's your ground, and then the middle wire, or the middle tab on your switch. I don't know why. One's normally open, one's normally closed. Okay, let's do this wire, which looks like blue and yellow. Blue and yellow goes on the bottom. So blue and yellow, I believe, goes there. Is that correct? Look at that again. Blue and yellow, yeah, goes right there. Right there. So that switch is bent a little bit, that's okay. Purple. Purple goes on the top switch. This one. Right here. Right? Yep. Okay. And then that is the orange and blue. Orange and blue. And maybe these are standard for like all JAMA. I don't know. It could be. I haven't learned that yet. Orange and blue goes on this switch. I believe that's orange and blue. Is that right? Okay. Then we've got black and yellow. Black and yellow goes on the other button. Right. And yellow goes there. Sure. Yeah, that looks right. And so this is orange and green. Orange and green should go over the side. On the bottom. Oh, yeah. You'd like to think order process of elimination. God, I wish I could extend that wiring a little bit. Let's see how it looks with the JAMA harness hooked in. Should be this one, I think. Player 2. We've got plenty of wire here, so it's not gonna hurt anything being that close, I guess. This is the only joystick I have mounted right now. So, alright. That should be everything. Let's try coiling it up and see what happens here. Just move the camera here.
camera to the side so you guys can actually see me. Pull it back a little bit more. All right. Still getting used to this tripod and camera and everything. There we go. All right, so everything's plugged in. Should be good to go. Should be able to pull our lock there. And let's see what happens. Shut this light off. You guys better look. Winners don't use drugs.
Pizza power!
First night I hooked this up, I just had this going. I was just listening to the song over and over and over.
Pizza power.
Let's kick shell!
Ooh, that's a good sign.
This is April.
Jump works, attack works, left works, right works, up works, down works. We're good. Let's play a little bit here. See how it feels. Oh, get out of here. Get out of your foot. Oh, yeah. People say that the original Turtles was more fun than Turtles in Time. I completely disagree, at least from my childhood, what I remember. I love Turtles in Time. God, that monitor looks good. It's a good looking monitor. I think it's like a Euro stick or something. Yeah, I don't know. Stick or something.
Pizza time!
It's time!
Yeah, but...
Oh, he just stood there! Eat it!
Prepare to die!
Get out of here, Crank! Oh no! Let me do it!
No!
Buttons feel good.
No!
Oh, I ran right into it. Such good music in this room. Well, I can't get out of here.
Pizza time! Terminate the turtle!
Before now, so we can just put this together and be done. But I
wants to wire the buttons. So I think we're just going to have to wait until we get the tumbler and tumble these, and then we'll keep going. But I think we're, and we need a bulb.
Need a light bulb.
For all the coin doors. And then I got to take these coin doors off. I don't know if you can see it here. Let's see. No, you can't see the coin doors. The coin doors are in pretty rough shape. They're like not mounted on there, like missing all the screws on that one. Wires cut. I really don't even know what these wires do. Or if they were supposed to be connected at all. I can probably follow them and see where they go here. They go down to the ground? No. Yeah. How am I cleaning up? There's no ground. Are they just extra grounds? Yeah, they're extra grounds. Is this the ground right here? Why would somebody want extra grounds unless they just... I don't know. I can't explain some of the things I did on this machine. I really can't. All right, well, I guess we'll wait until we get our tumbler. And then we'll come back. All right.